to my first online tango technique class. I tried to read all your comments below my post on Instagram and Facebook, and I will try to take care of all your requests. So let's start. I'll close my feet and open a little bit the ball of my foot. I soften my knees and try to move my weight from the left to the right, breathing in and breathing out in this way. Then I will try to lift one of my leg in this way and keep my weight. In this way, you have to take care of your axis that is not in the middle but is moved on the right side, so you will not be like this, but you have to push up your hip to stay in balance. Then I go down and I move my weight. I do the same, lifting the right leg. So you can look that this part of my body is not going down, but stay up. Then I turn so you can see better. I soften my right leg and I stretch the left one. I do this and there is no weight on the left. So you can check doing this movement and also try to feel that your hips are not doing this movement. So I lift my left and I open and close so I can feel the adductors moving inside, and I'm not doing movement from my foot, but I'm doing the movement from here. Then I close, I go down and I do the same going back. I lift, I open from here, I close, I go down and I change weight. The same with the right. So I stretch, I project the right leg, I lift it, I check my hips, I open, I close, I go to the center, I go down, and I do the same going backward. I lift, I open, I close, I go back to the center, and change weight. Another exercise that can be useful to be aware of your feet is stretching the leg, and then stretching your foot, and then when you go back, you go in this way. Okay, so stretching your leg, I go back and I do this movement so I can feel the floor when I go in front, and when I go backward, I go with the heel. I change weight and I do the same with the right. I stretch the right leg and I go backward. When my heel can't feel the floor anymore, I stretch my foot. So pay also attention in the way of my knee moves. In this position, it's stretched. When it goes forward, it's flexed. And the standing leg is always a little bit flexed. It's not like this. And talking about the balance and the posture, I want to remind you always to straighten your torso and to keep your weight a little bit slightly forward so that your free leg can behave like a pendulum, okay, in this way. So now let's start analyzing the walk. I go to do a step, I project, I push with my standing leg, and then I go with my heel. One, two, three, and then I release the left leg so it can keep the energy going, and then we go back. I push with the standing leg. One, two, three, and then I let the energy go in the free leg. Again, one, two, three, I let the energy go, and then backward. I always project, I project standing the knee, I project standing the foot. So it's not like this, it's not like this, I do this. And go one, two, three, and change weight. One, two, three, and now I release the right leg and go back. One, two, three, and go. One, two, three, release. One, two, three, change weight. It's like walking forward, but we have to insert the pivots. So I flex my right and I straighten my left. I push with the right to go on the left foot with the heel, and I push with the right foot. Now my left is softened and I go for the pivot. I turn my chest to the right while my hips are going to the left. I usually imagine to have an object in my hands and to move it in the opposite direction of my hips, so it's more easier to not lose the balance in this way. And from here, I do the same on the other side. I'm going to push with the left and I go with the heel of the right. I push also with my foot. Now my right leg is flexed and I'm ready for the pivot. My body is always in one direction. I'm going to move my object to the left while my hips are turning to the right.
Wow.
So we use the same idea also for the backward ocho. I'm going to straighten my left and move my weight while pushing with my right. And from this position, I move my object to the left while my hips are turning to the right. And then from here, I move my weight, I close my feet, my knees are closed in this position, I turn my chest to the right while my hips are turning to the left. And can you see that in this position there is no weight on the left? So first projection, then I move the weight, and then I turn. Changing weight. 5, 6, 7, and 8. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Let's do it backward. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Changing weight. 5, turning. 6, 7, and projecting 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. The cross. While usually when I walk, I take my heel always close to each other. In the position of the cross, I do exactly the opposite. I take the ball of my foot, of my feet together, and the heel are a little bit far from each other. You can also cross like this, it's not a problem, but you can't cross in this position, because when you are going to change the weight from a foot to another, your body on the top is going to move too much. So you have to keep the change of axis very close. And you can do this when the leader leads you a changing of weight, or you can do it as an adorno, like this, but always keeping close your feet. Okay, I'll show you now an exercise for the cross. Let's use the backward cross. I go back with the right. The standing leg is the left. It's flexed, and I'm going to stretch my foot to make space for the right to arrive. So in this way, when I change weight, even if it's a backward cross, I can work forward. Can you see that my foot is not making space in this way? I flex my knee and I stretch my foot. In this way, I can walk. The same is if I'm going with the forward cross and I can walk backward. So I go with the forward cross, I make space for my right to arrive, and it takes its place. Now both of my legs are flexed. I go to the forward cross with my left, and in the end my right leg straighten to make space for the right. Combining the cross with the ocho. Now I will start putting the cross before the pivot. So I go, crossing back, going to the center and turning. I can do the same going backward. After the pivot. So I first do the pivot, then I do the backward cross and go. First I do the pivot, backward cross and go. The same, going backward. First I do the pivot, I cross back and go. Let's try the same embellishment with the forward cross. So, first I'm going for the forward cross, then I go to the center and pivot. So, forward cross, center, pivot. And the same going backward, first the cross and then the pivot. Then I change the order. So first I do the pivot and then I cross. Center and go. Pivot, cross, center, go. Pivot, cross, center and go. And backward. First the turning, then the cross, and then I go. Another combination can be combining the cross with the pivot. Now we are separating them, but we can also keep the cross while turning. So for the backward cross, it's going to be like this. First I cross, then I pivot. And the same going backward. First I cross, then I keep the cross while pivoting. And then with the other cross, with the forward cross, then pivoting. And going backward, the last combination that I want to show you is with the two crosses and the pivot all together. Of course there are many possibilities, but we are going to see only one. And so I go for the forward ocho, I do the forward cross, then I go for the backward cross while pivoting, go to the center and go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. The same I can do going backward. I go with the backward cross, I turn while pivoting, forward cross, and then backward ocho. So thank you for watching this first class. I hope it can be useful for your dance. And please follow the group on Facebook, Free Online Classes by Michael and Silvina, so that you can receive our last videos. And so hope to see you in the next events live.
El